Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social This Side, and today we are going to record this video as per your demand, as you were requested to record videos on SSIS interview questions and answers. So this is the first video I am going to record on the SSIS interview questions and answers. So this is totally dependent on the transitions. So before going forward, if you haven't watched SSIS tutorial part 52, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video where you can understand about the transitions in the SSIS. So before jumping next slide, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, so I would strongly recommend to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification of the newly uploaded videos. So move to next slide. So here, as we can see, we are having three data flow tasks, first, second and third. So the question is, we just want to load that data from data flow task 1 and 2. If any one of these will be failed, then other should be rolled back and third data flow task will be moved forward. So third will not be dependent on the first and second, but first and second both are dependent will each other. As I have created few scenarios over here, as we can see in the input, we are having data flow task 1, data flow task 2, data flow task 3. If data flow task 1 will be completed with success and second will be failed. So in the output, we just want to roll back data flow task 1 and 2 both. In the second scenario, as we can see, if the first data flow task will be failed and second will success. So the first and second will be rollbacked because first is rollbacked. If both will be succeed, then both will be committed. If any one will be failed, then that second should be rollbacked. So how we can design our package? As of now, we have only these three data flow tasks. So I would suggest just pause this video and think about this, how we can set up this scenario, because here we are having data flow task 3, which is not dependent with the data flow task 1 or 2. It will be run independently. So how we can design? So go to on SSDT, and here, as you can see, we are having these three data flow tasks. Let's have a look of flat files. So we are having flat file 1, 2 and 3. So in the T1, we are having 5 columns and 5 rows. So that is good. And here we are loading this data into SQL Server table. So let's have a look of SQL Server table. So this is a table. Let me refresh this. So as of now, we don't have any data into this table. So here, these three data flow tasks will dependent with each other. So let me execute this package and we'll see. So as we can see, all these have been executed successfully. Now I stop this package and go to on SQL Server table. And let me refresh this table. So as we can see, we are having 15 records. So just delete that one. Yes, good. Now go to on flat file and let me create few custom error on this. So just create this custom error on the flat file 2. Now I just want to execute the package. So once I execute this package, then first will be completed with success and third will be completed. Second is failed. But here go to on table and let me refresh this. So we are having 10 records because first and third is completed with success. So what our requirement is, we don't want to load the data for first data flow task if second will be failed. So I would suggest we can use the sequence container. So let me drag and drop the sequence container, and here let me put these data flow tasks inside this sequence container, and let me set the transaction property for this sequence container with the required. So go to on properties, and here as we can see, transaction options that is supported, let me change with required. So now a new transaction will be created at the sequence container level, and go to on data flow task. So in the data flow task, let me check the transaction option, so that is supported. So it will join the existing transaction. So in the second, it will also supported, so it will again join the transaction. So now this will be the part of sequence container, and a transaction will be created at the sequence container level. So these two will be the part of the transaction. Now let me execute this package and see the output. So as we can see, this is failed. Good. Data flow task is completed with success. Stop this package. Go to on table. Let me refresh this. So we are having only 5 records. So that looks good. But the interviewer asks one more question after this. Here we have created the sequence container and set the required transaction option for this sequence container. If we set the transaction option for this data flow task 1 as not supported, then what will be happened? So here, don't get confused with this question. So let me set this not supported. In this case, this will not be part of the transaction. So don't confuse with this question. Now in the table, we will have 10 records, 5 from this data flow task 3 and 5 from this data flow task 1. Let me execute this. That looks good. Stop this package and go to on table. Let me refresh this. It should have 10 rows. So as we can see, we are having 10 rows. So this is the question. Don't get confused about this. If we set not supported, so it will not be part of the transaction anywhere. I hope you have understand this first question. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification, and do comment if you want more SSIS interview questions and answers. Thank you so much for watching this video.